On behalf of the Robotics Education and Competition Foundation, welcome to the 2020 VEX Robotics Virtual World Championship Celebration presented by Northrop Grumman Foundation. I am Dan Mann, CEO of the REC Foundation. I know we're all disappointed that we're not in Louisville right now watching the world's best VEX Robotics competing against each other. For the next hour, we will still celebrate our great season by playing Fantasy Robotics, recognizing some incredible teams and volunteers, and hear about some great new VEX Robotics products and revealing next season's challenge. We all know that the REC Foundation's mission is to increase student interest and involvement in STEM by engaging students in hands-on, affordable, and sustainable robotics programs. And by all accounts, our 2019-2020 season was a huge success. The number of robotics teams in our program soared this year to over 27,000 teams. We now have over 300,000 students competing on VEX Robotics teams in over 60 countries. It's amazing to think this all started just 13 years ago with a handful of teams. Our Girl Powered initiative continues to make robotics reflective of the diverse world we live in. We increased the participation of young women on VEX Robotics teams from 23% back in 2016 to over 40% this season. I want to give a special thanks to Texas Instruments for hosting the flagship event in Dallas for the third straight year. And thanks to Google for hosting 7 different girl-powered workshops for girls to build and program robots, including our first workshop in Singapore. Over the next year, the REC Foundation and Google aim to host 20 workshops at Google facilities across the world. This was the second year of our JROTC VEX Robotics program. Over 50 JROTC schools built robots and competed for the first time. They were even going to have their own national championship in Louisville today. Our partnership with National Technical Institute for the Deaf Regional STEM Center also continues to flourish. This year, deaf and hard of hearing students from over 50 teams in 20 states competed in VEX Robotics. And we started a new aerial drones competition with For the Win to reach more students to engage them in hands-on STEM activity. We had more events than ever before. Our dedicated event partners hosted over 2,000 VEX Robotics competitions this past season. Without them and the volunteers, there would be no competitions. Thank you. You are the engine that drives all this. I want to recognize Northrop Grumman for their 9th year of continued support. We'll hear from them a little bit later, but they have been presenting sponsor for the 7th straight years. We had to cancel the VEX Robotics World Championship this year. They reached out to offer their continued support to do something to celebrate the season. So thank you, Northrop Grumman Foundation, for all that you do to provide the opportunity for hundreds of thousands of students to experience robotics and learn STEM skills. To my staff, thank you. It can be a demanding and difficult job, and this year was particularly challenging with all the new programs, new organization structure, and then the canceled events. I know you are more disappointed than even the students that we cannot be together in Louisville to celebrate the season and catch up and spend time with each other. But at least you're not having to listen to my mandatory season recap. But from the bottom of my heart, thank you for believing in our mission and believing in me and making a true impact in this world. I love to travel to VEX Robotics events across the country and world. For the first time, I visited events outside the United States. I had the great experience of watching VEX IQ teams compete in the World Skill Juniors Mobile Robotics Competition in Kazan, Russia. And I want to thank Shanghai Jiao Tong University for showing me all the great robotics programs that they support. And thank Alibaba for hosting me at their VEX Worlds qualifying event in Chongqing, China. It was a remarkable experience and event. The best part of traveling to VEX Robotics events is meeting the event partners, coaches, and students, and to hear their stories. Our teachers, coaches, parents are truly dedicated. They really want what is best for their students. And to the students, you are amazing. I appreciate you challenging me to remember this is about you and that we need to listen. I love to hear about how you got started in robotics and your plans for the future. These conversations and experience truly inspire me. You know what else is inspiring? The online resources developed by VEX Robotics and RoboMatter. The STEM Lab's educational resources are amazing and provide free, easy-to-follow lesson plans. When educators really needed activities for students learning from home, VEX developed and released VEX Code VR in less than a month. VEX Code VR allows students to code a virtual robot using block-based coding. See the roboticseducation.org site or the VEX Robotics websites to learn more. finally, I want to give a special shout out to all the VEX Robotics teams out there that are using their STEM skills to 3D print face shields, help local communities maintain medical equipment, and provide overall support to their communities. Please watch the story of VEX teams 9871 and 3510 that built robots to motorize hospital bed tables. With these same types of efforts from many of our 27,000 robotics teams, we will soon be back to school and competing. Please enjoy the rest of today's celebration.
We've had a lot of discussions in the industry about this word called telehealth. And the concept is to keep providers safe from going into a room of any potentially infected patient, to keep caregivers safe. And the idea arose about, well, if we can do telemedicine, why not do some sort of robotic mechanism to keep our nurses equally as safe? And so out of that idea, the idea was born, and the robotics department of the local ISDs came up as an idea. We made contact, and the student said, great, we'll get right on it in 2 weeks. And we said, we need it by tomorrow.
The entire idea is to have a way to deliver meds to patients without a nurse who might potentially be carrying the illness to go into the room. My guess is that this will be really helpful for patients who have cancer, who are on chemotherapy, who have repressed immune system, or people who are sick with other diseases that make them more susceptible to having the serious symptoms for COVID-19.
We sent bed tables to them Saturday morning, and so by Saturday evening, Abilene and Wiley both had two prototypes for us to look at and see if this would work. We brought it up to Zane Dennis, which is in charge of our facilities here, and he got with Tiger Manufacturing.
They asked if we could build them three stainless box covers to help with the sterilization of the equipment, and they needed it in a fast way. This is what we come up with in the fabrication part, was the stainless box cover for the robotic wheels. These are all prototypes. We fabricated three of these in about 7 hours. Then the box above it is the components for the robot, the remote receiver and such. Anything we can do to help the community, the surrounding areas, especially on the health crisis we're in right now, we're more than happy to help with if there's anything we can do.
I got an email at 8:40 on Saturday morning, and I said, you know what, we can do this. And then my second thought was, I have to get my students involved. But I was really glad that I brought my kids on board because, you know, we cranked it out all Saturday and then Sunday morning. So we got it done in like 9 hours.
We used our VEX Robotics parts. They come in a competition kit that we were using from our school. And all the parts that we used were either made out of aluminum or steel. Most of the parts that we used were made out of aluminum because it's lighter. VEX makes smart motors, which will connect to their brain, which can be programmed with the wireless remote. We just had to figure out how to get our robotics parts to work with the existing like table infrastructure and like how it was built.
You would put it all together and then there'd be something that's not quite right, so you'd have to take a bunch of it apart. It feels really good because it's nice to inspire something like this and be able to create and help out people.
Went through several different prototypes, but in the end, we've got something that appears to work.
The beautiful thing about this is that nurses are used to dealing with battery-operated systems with their IV systems. And so as long as they treat it like an IV and always have it plugged in before they go to use it, it should be business as usual for most of the nursing staff.
What's your name?
Tracy.
Tracy, I'm Zane. This is Dwayne.
Nice to meet you.
I'm the facility director. Dwayne's the IT director at Hendrick.
But it does have a little bit of pressure because we don't want excessive pressure on these motors because it's going to be really hard on them.
Well, you'll take them out.
Well, and we'd also have a tendency to pop a wheelie.
Have you tried it like with, I'm going to say a load on it, but when I say a load, like a patient tray that would have like food on it, 15 pounds, so that's more than enough weight, don't you think?
Yes, oh, yeah, unless you have
they're using styrofoam trays.
If you notice the PPE or the gowns and masks, we want to use those where we can save them, so we can basically take the robot in bed table into the room, be able to do FaceTime with the patients, family members, doctors, and staff. We started at 8 o'clock on Saturday morning, and then Tuesday morning we'll be able to use those in the room.
not only are these great innovators helping the hospital, I hope they do something extraordinary like patent this information, because I'd like to get this out to every hospital or quarantined unit, because I can see this revolutionizing the way we deliver healthcare.
Thank you, Dan, for that great opening. My name is Jim Myers, and I am Northrop Grumman's Vice President of Programs. I wish we were all together in Louisville, Kentucky at the VEX Robotics World Championship. Unfortunately, that is not possible this year. I will truly miss the energy and enthusiasm in the arena and the excitement on everyone's faces. On behalf of Northrop Grumman and the Northrop Grumman Foundation, I want to thank everyone from all corners of the globe for joining together with us at the 2020 VEX Robotics Virtual World Championship Celebration. I am thrilled to be here to say a few words about how important the areas of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics are to our citizens, to our country, to our world, and of course to the world of robotics. Everything you see around you, from the computers you are streaming this on, to the furniture you sit on, to the cell phone that you have and use, to the cars we drive, everything was designed by someone who is a trained technologist or who is using technology to enable rapid design, rapid prototyping, and rapid development. It is young minds like yours that continue to shape our technology-based industries, including aerospace. At Northrop Grumman, we hire the best and brightest people to conceptualize and solve the most vexing problems, from cyberspace to undersea to outer space, and everything in between, including, of course, robotics. As you all know, we already use robotic technologies in our daily lives and have been for many years, including manufacturing, agriculture, mining, healthcare. How about the use of exoskeletons to enable patients with paralysis to walk again? Military security applications, including explosive bomb disposal and making repairs to critical equipment in the undersea and outer space domains, to name a few. The future is virtually limitless for all of you interested in robotics, autonomous systems, and related technology areas. Each and every one of you are motivated by your imaginations, by discovery, experimentation, by pushing the limits of our knowledge. Your talents applied in STEM fields will result in innovations that will make a profound difference and positive impact to our communities, our country, and the world. Think about the innovations in medicine in recent years. Surgeries that either couldn't be performed a generation ago or were quite invasive are now commonplace and becoming routine because of the application of robots to the operating room, including certain surgeries for cancer, transplants, and cardiac procedures. And in our current environment, where we need our healthcare professionals to be protected from the COVID-19 virus, robotics has a huge role to play, potentially isolating the patient from the healthcare professionals while still enabling them to provide critical care. In case you were curious about my background, like so many involved in STEM fields, I too did engineering and design and engineering development of a robotic end effector for the space station early in my career. So as someone with a technical background and a career in a technology-based industry like aerospace, I am keenly aware of the accelerating pace of innovation. The 21st century is truly an amazing time for STEM professionals. I believe STEM study places you on a wonderful path to many exciting professional opportunities and achievements. From all of us at Northrop Grumman and the Northrop Grumman Foundation, congratulations on an amazing 2019-2020 competition season. Have a great summer, and I look forward to seeing you in person in Dallas at the 2021 VEX Robotics World Championship.
Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on where you're watching from out there in the VEX Nation. Each year, I have the distinct pleasure and the honor of being your host in Louisville. My name is Grant Cox, and I'm also the chairman of the GDC. VEX Worlds is hands down one of my favorite weeks of the year every year. I get to meet, watch, cheer for, and just generally be blown away by the top VEX competition teams in the world. You've made it. You're the best of the best. But this year, for the first time in VEX history, that experience, or at least the one that we've grown used to, will not be happening. But that does not mean that the experiences of the squared away season should be left behind. VEX Worlds represents just a small fraction of the 125,000 matches that were played this season. That's a lot of matches. While we're doing some statistics, do you have any guesses at how many cubes were scored in all of the matches this season? That's green cubes, red cubes, blue cubes. How many? Stay tuned, I'll let you know the answer in a little later in the broadcast. So if there's one thing I want you to take away from this year's changes to the end of the season, it's that your season as a whole should not solely be measured or remembered by your accomplishments on a big stage with lasers and confetti. VEX World is not just a competition. It never has been. It should be a celebration of your hard work and your accomplishments from the past 12 months. Now, with that being said, we do give out some trophies for performance on the field. It may not just be a competition, but it's still a competition. When the difficult decision was made to cancel VEX Worlds in Louisville, a team of staff from the REC Foundation and VEX Robotics realized that we've got the data, we've got the matches that the teams played throughout the season, all 125,000 of them, we have the list of teams that qualified for VEX Worlds, we have spreadsheets, let's have some fun with the data. Let's find a way to look at the best of the best, put on our Doctor Strange cloak, and simulate one possible outcome for how those teams would have played with each other. So, without further ado, welcome VEX Nation to the 2020 VEX Fantasy Robotics Tournament. Here's how the tournament is going to work. We've split up the teams who qualified for VEX Worlds into divisions and generated qualification match schedules made of randomly assigned alliance partners, just like you would in a normal tournament. There are qualification matches, division elimination matches, and world championship finals matches, just as there would have been at VEX Worlds. Now, in a real-life tournament, teams might bring their robots, they might bring their drivers, their coaches, they might bring their season experience, and try to score as many points as possible in their matches by combining these things. This year, in the fantasy tournament, you might not have your robots, you might not have your drivers, but you do still have your season experience that you're going to be using to score as many points as possible. Let me explain what I mean. Each team in the fantasy tournament is coming in with a simulation set of scores. This set represents the top 15 scores from a team's entire squared away season. In the qual matches, you'll be paired with another team who has their own set of scores. In each match, one score will be randomly chosen from each team's simulation set. These two scores will be averaged together, and that will be the alliance score for that match. Once a score has been used, it is removed from the set, and it cannot be used again in any future matches. If these two teams were to play together again, those scores are not available anymore, but two new scores would be chosen in the future match. This second match, they scored 55 points. Great job, teams. Now that those two scores have been used, they are scratched out from their simulation set as well. Once all of the qualification matches have been played and the teams have been ranked by their alliance scores, it'll be time for the playoffs. Teams pair up by rank, just like normal, and face off against each other using one last remaining score from their simulation set. The winner of that outcome will be a division champion. They'll do the whole thing again between the divisions, and that winner will be your 2020 Fantasy Robotics Tournament Champion. The match lists are ready to go, so we're going to go ahead and let the simulation run for a while we take a look at some of the highlights from the season. I'll be back a little bit later once we have some results to report, and then I'll see you for the reveal of the 2020-2021 VEX IQ Challenge Game.
Hello, VEX teams. Like all of you, NASA would have loved to be with you and your robots in Kentucky. But we are still delighted to be here with you celebrating the 2020 VEX Virtual Worlds. NASA's Robotics Alliance project is proud to support VEX and the RECF. RAP is dedicated to increasing interest in engineering and science among America's youth. It is our goal to create an inspired, experienced, technical workforce for the aerospace community. Not only is NASA proud to be the American Space Agency, but we are also developing life-saving technologies that are helping fight the COVID-19 pandemic. We are deeply saddened this must be done virtually, as we all know how hard you have worked over the past year. Your work is not lost, as you have gained new valuable skills and finely tuned problem-solving methods which will be invaluable in the coming years. Just like you, NASA engineers are experts at problem-solving. Building rovers, satellites, rockets, and everything in between is full of challenges we must overcome. NASA is excited to be going to Mars next year with the Perseverance Mars rover. Along with the rover, NASA is sending the first ever drone to be flown on another planet. In addition to Mars, NASA is actively building a new moon rover and is bringing humans back to the moon in 2024. Please do not forget, the future is bright for each and every one of you. We will be back together on the robotics playing field soon. Until then, sharpen your skills and improve upon your engineering knowledge, because NASA and the world needs engineers now, more than ever. You are the best of the best. And thank you for keeping your spirits high through this adversity. You are an inspiration to us all. And with you, NASA and America have a great future. Thank you again. Let's go celebrate.
Hello from Texas. My name is Tony Norman. I'm the co-founder and co-inventor of VEX Robotics. Bob and I, which you'll hear from Bob later, Bob and I created VEX to give students the tools they need to shape their future. And that commitment continues today. Earlier this year, we were super excited to announce VEX 123 for students that are kindergarten through second grade. We also announced VEX Go for kids in grades 3 through 4. This made VEX the first company to achieve the full continuum from K through college in the same ecosystem. But even with this major accomplishment, we're not willing to stop there. Let me explain. So, some of you high school students and college students have been involved in VEX for many years and have mastered the competition by the end of the program. So we need more tech and another challenge to keep pushing the limits. We have that technology to do it now. The launch of V5 is the perfect example of how VEX leads the robotic space with state-of-the-art equipment that is scalable and affordable. V5 took many years of research and development. But when we released it, we did not give you everything we were working on. What we are about to show you is the next phase of V5. You're not just going to see new sensors. We're going to show you a whole new level of tech in competition robotics. So now, without further delay, I introduce you to the most advanced technology and program in competitive robotics today.
Wow, Tony, there was a lot of new technology in that video. Hi, I'm Bob Mimlich, co-founder and co-inventor of VEX Robotics. What you just saw was an AI we built for Tower Takeover, and we're retraining that AI now for the next game and waterproofing all the parts. One thing we learned was that AI alone is just not enough. I'm sure you all know that location is critical for just 15 seconds of autonomous, so the GPS was actually the most important part of making this new game possible. The printed GPS field code is the key. The VEX GPS sensor uses that field code like real GPS uses satellites to triangulate position. Once we had GPS and AI working, we used something called sensor fusion along with robot-to-robot communications to make those amazing top view maps you saw. Now let's talk about that game. 2 minutes? Four robots? No drivers. Wow, that's gonna be a real world challenge. The game is separate from VRC and VEXU. Each team brings two robots that communicate with each other. You can 3D print parts, you can machine parts, you can use custom electronics, and there's no pesky motor quantity limits. This game will be open to high school students and college students alike. We can't wait to see how you play this new game. You have to convert your strategy and driver skills into code. Just like chess, you have to anticipate your opponent's every move in code. You can watch that video again at ai.vex.com. Oh, and one more thing. I know a lot of you are at home right now without a robot. We just released a new tool that lets you learn to code at home. VEXCode VR uses the same coding tools as IQ and V5, but on a virtual robot. Go to vr.vex.com to try it out. I hope you enjoy using all the new products. Thank you all, and stay safe.
Hello, I'm Calvin Johnson, a program manager in STEM education at Google, and I am thrilled to announce the winners of the Community Award Online Challenge. The Community Award Online Challenge, sponsored by Google, is presented to VRC or VEXU teams that make a positive impact on STEM education opportunities in their community through leadership, outreach, mentorship, and support. The winning teams made many contributions outside their school or organizations that help students, teams, coaches, or mentors. These contributions may span multiple seasons and are not limited to REC Foundation or VEX Robotics programs. They may include any robotics or STEM education program. We are happy to announce the winners of the Community Award Online Challenge are Team 373 from Rancho Rio, New Mexico, with STEM strength in numbers. Team 449X from Riverside, California, with 449X leadership and outreach. Team 1669 from Milpitas, California, with MXR 1669X Community Award submission. Team 2602G from Hopkinton, Massachusetts, with Back to the Community. Team 6526G from Laverne, California, with Damien Spartan Robotics Community Award. Team 8787E from El Paso, Texas, with Eastwood Robotics Community Service. Team 41091A from Union, Kentucky, impacting the next generation. Team 4837M from Wangaratta, Australia, with Galen Vex, engaging our community. Team 82855G from Richmond Hill, Ontario, with SLT Robotics, the family. And finally, Team 94927A from Morgan Hill, California, with Robotics Worldwide. From all of us here at Google, we would like to thank these teams for their commitment and contributions to STEM education and their communities. Great work, and congratulations.
Eastwood Robotics presents its Community Award. Starting in 2016, with over 350 girls, 2019 has brought us our largest Girl Power Conference yet, of over 800 attendees. Each year, we have expanded our event by partnering with other high schools, our University of Texas here in El Paso, and our local companies to encourage girls by showcasing different areas of STEM. From learning about this year's VEX IQ game, trying out virtual reality goggles for the first time, designing their own binary bracelets, and learning about game design and drones, these girls are taught their opportunities are limitless. We are Girl Powered El Paso. This year, we partnered with El Paso Electric to film our first commercial. Hosted in our very own robotics room, our team participated in this commercial to promote robotics and the innovative work in developing STEM projects to better prepare our youth for careers of the 21st century. Also partnering with the SCTE Foundation, we were able to get a $15,000 check to help develop new robotics teams across the city. With SCTE, we were also able to host free summer camps at different schools where new teams built their first robots and competed in mini challenges. We also partnered with our Fort Bliss to host free VEX IQ elementary and middle school tournaments. From middle and elementary schools, science fairs, and even our water company, we have presented across our city to promote robotics teams and what they can accomplish. This year, we were able to mentor teachers across the city school districts in VEX IQ building and programming language. We have participated in parades to brand our Troopers logo and showcase our team. Last year, we collected new clothing items and basic necessities to donate to the large group of our city's migrants. We have certified each of Eastwood's robotics classes in Robot C. Each year, we help host our city's VEX IQ and EDR tournaments, from hosting at our own school to lending fields, participating as referees and judges, and planning the tournament schedules and setups. We are expanding the opportunities for young students to explore their passions and talents at a much younger age than ever before. We have also mentored VEX IQ teams at our nearby elementary and middle schools and sponsor a mini Troopers team. Lastly, because of these tournaments, trainings, and certifications, we are proud to say we have played a huge role in expanding VEX robotics district-wide K-12. We are Eastwood 8787.
Thank you, REC, for allowing me to be here to present this award today. At Dell Technologies, we are committed to driving human progress. Our vision for 2030 articulates how we'll create this social impact. With our technology and skill, we will advance health, education, and economic opportunity to deliver enduring results to over 1 billion people by the year 2030. I'm thrilled to present the award for the Robotics Team Website Challenge, sponsored by Dell Technologies. This challenge required teams to develop a website that promoted their robotics programs and the benefits of robotics education. And the winners of the Robotics Team Website Challenge are Team 7335T, Doge Yeet from Taiwan, and Team 2131, Exothermic Robotics from Washington State. Congratulations to all teams on your success.
Girl Powered is an initiative to redefine the face of STEM by creating a more inclusive environment for all students within the robotics community. Google sponsored this challenge to help foster a community that encourages equal participation of young women and men in competitive robotics. We searched for compelling, engaging stories that give us insight into how you've taken the Girl Powered initiative and incorporated it into your experience on a VEX IQ Challenge team. The 2020 VEX IQ Girl Powered Online Challenge Award goes to, in first place, Team 3204B from Palmerston North, New Zealand. In second place, Team 92H from Chester Springs, Pennsylvania, USA. And in third place, Team 1845A from Hattiesburg, Mississippi, USA. From all of us here at Google, great work and congratulations on an amazing 2019-2020 competition season.
Thank you for allowing me to present the Autodesk CAD Make It Real online challenge. In this challenge, students were asked to use the same Autodesk 3D design software used by the professionals, such as Autodesk Fusion 360 or Autodesk Inventor and Tinkercad, to conceptualize and model a new part for a robot that improves the robot's functionality or overcomes an existing problem. The new part must be designed to fit an existing robot and may consist of multiple pieces that form a one-part design. The robot may be a competition robot or another robot that performs an interesting task. To make it even more exciting, teams also had the option to compete for a bonus prize by 3D printing their custom part. The winners of this challenge are for VEXU, Queen, from Kingston, Ontario, Canada, with low-friction slider truck. High school, team 5106C, from North Conway, New Hampshire, USA, with VEX nameplate holder. Middle school VRC, team 2211A, from Caguas, Puerto Rico, with the hook. Elementary school, team 69639A, from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario, Canada, with IQ shaft extender. And the bonus prize for 3D printing goes to team 1691A from Cary, North Carolina, USA, with screw helical gears for VEX Robotics.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the 2020 VEX Fantasy Robotics Tournament. We've had the simulation running in the background, and we now have our division champions from all of the VEX IQ Challenge divisions. Remember, this is just for fun. It's just a simulation using the top scores that teams achieved during the season, but it still gives us a chance to recognize some of the best and see how they would have done against each other, could have done against each other. Before we dive into the results though, I do have the answer from the trivia question earlier. Remember, how many cubes do you think were scored in the squared away season? If you said 100,000, you'd be too low. If you said 300,000, you'd still be too low. If you said 406,000 cubes scored in all of the events throughout the season, you'd be our winner. That's a lot of cubes. So, without further ado, let's find out who our division champions were in the fantasy tournament. Remember which division you were in and watch for your team number as we scroll through. First up, in the elementary school side of things, is the Apollo division, where your champions were team 66889B, the fifth team of Extracurricular Educational Activity Center of Nanning Primary and Secondary Schools, and 2048H Hooba Looba from Traverse City, Michigan. I like Hooba Looba. I think that might be my favorite name so far. Next up in the elementary school side is Cassini, where your champions were 1111B, the BarkBots Fruity Legends from Cupertino, California, and 3518A, the Fushu Goshan Center Primary School from Fushan, China. In the Chandra division, it was 88299A, Science Museum 1 from Beijing, China, and 46033D, Phoenix 3 from Beijing, China. All Beijing Alliance in the Chandra side. In Hubble, it was 7788A, North Star from Beijing, China, and 88299B, Science Museum 2, also from Beijing, China. In the Viking division, we had team 94568B, Vexotics Basketbots from San Ramon, California, and 5077D, We Want to Be Number One from Shaanxi, China. Well, 5077D, you were number one, in Viking at least, so we'll find out a little later if you were number one overall. In Orion, we had team 27052B, Huahe Road Primary School 2 from Henanil, China, and 94666A, that means Little Dolphin from Jiangsu, China. That wraps up elementary school. Congratulations to all of those teams. We'll go over to middle school next. In the science division, we were greeted by 33111C, the Biscuits from Friendswood, Texas, and 11173A, Mililani Masters from Mililani, Hawaii. Congratulations to those teams. Our winners from the technology division, 99900J, the Dr. X Academy from Ontario, Canada, and 22250B, the Pack from Anaheim Hills, California. Winning the research division, it was team 16868A Python from Markham, Ontario, and 2956X Cerulean Blue from Bourne, Texas. Couple Texas teams coming out on top in VEX IQ Challenge. I like to see it. Yeehaw. winning the engineering division. We had team 647X, Bot Camp X, and 1122-6B, Star Maker 2F from Guangdong, China. In the arts division, your champions were 6868F, Roborobo Qingzhong 2 from Zhejiang, China, and 60373A, Roborams IQ from Miami, Florida. That's a team I would have loved to see compete in person. Maybe we'll see them next year. In the math division, we've got team 8599B, the Shanghai Zhujuan Primary School United Team from Shanghai, China, and 95699A, Vexcelerate from London, United Kingdom. All international alliance there. In the physics division, it was team 8666A, Shanghai Senfudu Robot A from Shanghai, China. Their partners were 30040A, VCMS Robotics A from Cumming, Georgia. That wraps up the VEX IQ Challenge Division Champions in the 2020 Fantasy Robotics Tournament. We'll check back a little bit later. These teams are all going to get one last chance to use their last remaining simulation set scores to determine your 2020 Fantasy Tournament Champions. I'll be back a little bit later to check in with that. And then something else, the reveal of the 2020-2021 VEX IQ Challenge Game. I'll see you in a bit.
Do you want to pursue a career in STEAM? Let me introduce you to the VEX IQ Challenge and how it can prepare you for your future. VEX IQ is a program where you build your own robots and compete in one-minute matches with other teams.
How can a one-minute match change your future, you might be asking?
Well, we will tell you how.
We are Nova IQ Robotics Team 99808A, and we believe that robotics is preparing us for careers in STEAM.
If you want to be a scientist, you'll learn firsthand about concepts like torque, friction, and center of gravity when you build a robot. Like scientists, we gather data, test, experiment, and analyze our results.
If you like technology, you can code autonomous and teleoperated programs that'll prepare you if you want to be a programmer or a computer scientist.
If you want to be an engineer, we use the engineering design cycle to design, build, test, and improve our robot over time. If you do the cycle correctly, the robot at the end of the season will be vastly improved over your earliest robot.
If you like art, you'll enjoy blueprinting and designing pages in the engineering notebook. We won the design award twice at Worlds because of our dedication to the engineering design process and our notebook.
And finally, if you want to be a mathematician or an actuary, we use math in our program, measurements, gear ratios, and averages.
If you want to pursue a career in STEAM, then the VEX IQ Challenge is the path for you.
Hi, my name is Steve Rummel, Senior Regional Support Manager and Chair of the RAC Foundation's Student Advisory Board. This year, the RAC Foundation brought together a diverse group of student competitors to provide feedback and insight on ways that we can improve the competition experience. The Student Advisory Board members looked at a range of issues, including ways to support new teams, increasing referee consistency, and enhancing the quality of the judging experience across all events, in addition to other issues. So on behalf of the RAC Foundation, I want to thank all our Student Advisory Board members, Ashwin, Kaushik, Lily, Samantha, Son, Elizabeth, David, and Jamie, for their service and work during this season. And congrats to all the teams who competed this year. And we look forward to a 2020-2021 VEX Robotics competition season. Good luck and thank you.
Hey everyone, my name is Lily Coffin and I'm a member of the Student Advisory Board. I've been on team 1353P at Farmingdale High School in Southern New York for 3 years now. I'm an engineer and a programmer, and when I grow up, I want to go to Mars. I've loved being on the Student Advisory Board because, like many of you, I've put a lot into VEX Robotics, and it's been really cool to see my experience and everything I've learned get channeled into some new productive changes that I hope will make the VEX experience even better in the future. Obviously, everything we talk about is very classified, but I hope you will all get to see the results of the hard work that we've been putting in over the past year sometime soon. It's been an honor to represent all the students worldwide who love VEX just as much as I do, and I want to thank everybody who made the board possible. I hope you all enjoy the new game that will be splashing your way soon. Good luck next year.
Hi everyone, my name is Kaushik, and I'm a VEX alum who's on the RECF Student Advisory Board. Throughout the past year, I've had the opportunity to interact with several other members across the globe and share some ideas on how to improve the VEX Robotics competition experience for all participants. The topics we've discussed include making it easier to get started with VEX in order to encourage the formation of new teams, as well as improving the competitor experience by increasing the consistency of referee rulings and judging across events. And hearing perspectives on VEX from people across the globe has really been eye-opening. VEX meant a lot to me when I competed. It was a way for me to develop my creativity and problem-solving skills while meeting many new people and making memories to last a lifetime. I hope VEX has done or will do the same for you.
Hey there, my name's Ruby and I'm with the REC Foundation and I am staying home and staying safe. I am super excited because I get to share this year's Inspiration All-Star Award winners with you. So let's jump in and let's get started. What is an Inspiration All-Star, you may ask? Well, let me tell ya. They could be a teacher, a mentor, a volunteer. They're really anybody who is devoted to the VEX competition experience, and they put in tons of hours of work. They're persistent, they're passionate, they're energetic. They help students. They help students achieve their goals. They help enrich their journeys. They really just show true leadership and dedication to the VEX competition experience. And I'm really excited that I get to share them with you today.
On weekends during the season, you'll find this all-star serving as a judge advisor for engineering notebooks. And when she's at events where there aren't engineering notebooks, she's in the stands, mentoring parents and students so that they understand the engineering design process. Having served as a volunteer judge at the VEX Robotics World Championship and at state championship events, she does everything she can to make sure that students have the opportunity to grow and learn. Always encouraging. The light in a dark room, inspirational kindness that spreads to everyone she knows. We're proud to present Barbara Harrington with our Inspiration All-Star Award. Congratulations, Barbara. Now let's take a look back and see what her students had to say about her during the nomination process.
Hi, I'm Mara.
My name is Shriyama.
I'm Kaden.
Hello, my name is Shabni.
And we are Team 53976A Girl Power. We are nominating Miss Barbara for the All-Star Inspire Award.
Here are a few encouraging quotes from her.
It's your story. Why not make it on the first?
You can't do this. Yet.
Good luck, Miss Barbara. We love you and you inspire us.
Hi, this is Team 53976D.
We are nominating Miss Barbara for the All-Star Inspire Award.
Thank you for all the things you do for us.
We're always thinking about your quotes that inspire us.
One time you said that when you think you've made something the best, make it even better.
Better is truly your favorite word.
You really deserve this award.
You rock!
A global inspiration from Canada to Australia. This all-star has passion, commitment, and infinite patience. Engaging with students, parents, and everyone he meets with dignity and respect, his gracious support and generous wisdom have helped shape the culture of the VEX community in Australia. An inspiration to parents to get involved to start robotics teams, his support and availability to help with any challenges have been instrumental and continue to impact teams and students in his area. We are proud to present Travis Burrows with the Inspiration All-Star Award. On behalf of everyone at the REC Foundation and VEX Robotics, I'd like to congratulate again all of our Inspiration All-Star winners.
Hello everybody, welcome back to the 2020 VEX Fantasy Robotics Tournament. The simulation has been churning in the background And basically all of our division champions had one last chance, just like they would have at VEX Worlds, to pull a score from their simulation set, which represents the best scores that they had during the regular season. Remember, this tournament's just for fun. It's an opportunity for us to recognize some of the best of the best, but somebody from the REC Foundation will be reaching out to you for some hardware. So congratulations to these teams. Let's meet them. On the elementary school side, coming out on top was teams 88299A, the Science Museum 1 from Beijing, China, and 46033D, Phoenix 3 from Beijing, China. Congratulations to the champions, as well as the finalists and the third place winners. Remember, all of the results will be posted on Robot Events about an hour after the broadcast if you want to dig into exactly how these teams did. On the middle school side, we had, coming out on top, 99900J Dr. X Academy from Richmond Hill, Ontario, and 22250B The Pack from Anaheim Hills, California. Again, congratulations to all of these teams. In order to win the VEX Fantasy Tournament, you don't just need to be good, you need to be consistent, because you have to have enough high-performing scores to last all the way until the finals. So these are two teams that I really would have loved to see compete in person. Maybe next year. Well, that concludes the Fantasy Robotics Tournament. This has been a lot of fun. We just have one thing left, and I know you know what it is. That's right. Get ready for the reveal of the 2020-2021 VEX IQ Challenge Game.
This arena is full of the most talented robotics students in the world. And we know why you're here today. You're all thinking the same thing. What's next? Because you've been through Crossover, you've experienced Ringmaster, you've crushed Next Level, and this year you dominated Squared Away. But this next challenge will stretch you. It will demand more from you as a team, and it will push you to the brink. So, are you ready? Introducing the 2020-2021 VEX IQ Challenge Game. Rise above.
Welcome to the 2020-2021 game, VEX IQ Challenge Rise Above. There are three ways to play VEX IQ Challenge Rise Above.
First, two teams will collaborate in 60-second teamwork challenge matches, working together to maximize their score. Both teams will receive the same points.
Each of these teams will consist of two drivers and one robot. One driver will operate the robot for the first half of the match, and the other driver will operate it for the second half.
Second, each team will have the opportunity to compete in the driving skills challenge. In these matches, teams have 60 seconds of driver-controlled time to score as many points as possible.
Third, each team will also have the opportunity to play programming skills challenge matches in which they have 60 seconds of autonomous robot operation to score points, no drivers allowed.
Scores from the driving and programming skills challenges will be combined to determine a robot skills challenge champion.
VEX IQ Challenge Rise Above is played on the new, wider field measuring 6 feet by 8 feet.
Robots and game objects start on the field in predetermined positions, and there are 9 goals located around the field.
Be sure to double check the robot size rules this year, as they may not be the same as previous VEX IQ Challenge games.
The scoring objects are risers with a height of approximately 8.75 inches and a width of approximately 7 inches. There are a total of 27 risers on the field.
The object of the game is to score as many points as possible with your alliance partner by scoring risers in goals and completing rows.
Each riser scored inside of a goal is worth 1 point. Each riser stacked on top is worth 1 additional point.
If teams score 3 risers of the same color in a row, they will have a completed row and will earn an additional 3 points.
If teams can stack 3 risers in the same goal, and that goal is part of a completed row, they will have a completed stack and will earn an additional 30 points.
Teams will have to experiment with different scoring configurations to figure out the most efficient way to score points.
For official game rules and robot requirements for VEX IQ Challenge Rise Above, please see the game manual found at roboticseducation.org and vexiq.com.
To register a team, find events near you, or ask a question on the official Q&A, please visit robotevents.com. Good luck and have a great season.
There it is. VEX IQ Challenge Rise Above. This is going to be a big game. I cannot wait to see how it gets played. Now, normally at VEX Worlds, I have a field here with me where I can show off some of the best features of the game. I don't have a field here. I have a cat and a fireplace, but don't have a field. However, since this is a virtual reveal, I do have a virtual field. So let's dive in and take a closer look. So right off the bat, obviously the first thing you notice, this is a big game. You know, we announced over the summer that beginning with this year's game and forevermore in the VEX IQ Challenge, our fields are gonna be 6 foot by 8 foot. But just because it's a bigger field does not mean there's a lot of room to move around. You know, take a look at from the sidelines. There is a lot of stuff in the way. So it's gonna take some skilled driving and good coordination with your partners to make sure that you score as efficiently as possible. Speaking of big, let's take a closer look at the risers. So the risers are some of the largest game objects that a VEX IQ Challenge robot has ever had to manipulate. Stacking 3 tall of these is going to be a tough challenge, but I know that VEX IQ teams are ready to rise to the occasion. You're also going to want to take a look at this way that the scoring rules work as far as connecting rows and large stacks. You're going to really want to strategize ahead of time to make sure that you optimize the scoring possibilities as much as possible. There's a lot of game objects on the field and not a lot of time to work with them. So this is going to be a fast-paced driver skill, robot skill, strategy skill game. I can't wait. Well, that about wraps it up for me. I have been Grant Cox, the chairman of the Game Design Committee, and usually your host in Louisville. I hope you've had as much fun with the virtual celebration as I have. I've got to sign off. I've got the game out. You can check out the game manual at roboticseducation.org or vexrobotics.com. And I will see you next year in Dallas, Texas.
As we close this year's first ever virtual VEX Robotics World Celebration, I'd like to again thank our presenting sponsor, Northrop Grumman Foundation, as well as all the additional sponsors who provided digital content and financial support to celebrate this virtual event with us. I would also like to thank all of our sponsors for another great season of supporting student engagement in STEM. I also want to recognize Louisville Tourism, as well as the Kentucky Expo Center and all of the Louisville vendors and supporters for hosting us at the World Championship for the past 6 years. We enjoyed our partnership with you and appreciate how you welcome tens of thousands of students and spectators to your great city every year. The 2021 VEX Robotics World Championship will move to the K. Bailey Hutchinson Convention Center in Dallas. We are thrilled to return home to Texas and share this great STEM city with our robotics community. The Dallas Sports Commission is working very hard to make this a memorable experience for all the students. To all the teams that qualified to the 2020 VEX Robotics World Championship, the REC Foundation is pleased to announce that we will be sending you your participation medals and pins. And to the 2020 Online Challenge winners, as well as the Community Award winners, I am pleased to tell you that your invitation will be extended to 2021. See you in Dallas. Finally, I would like to thank the REC Foundation and VEX Robotics staff working tirelessly to organize this event. And thank you, our viewers, for joining us to celebrate this first ever virtual event. I'm proud of our community's ability to adapt and to continue to engage in robotics and STEM even during times of adversity and challenge. Please stay home, follow social distancing, and stay safe. We will see you next season.